Hello, welcome to Let's Play EverQuest Classic on Project 1999. I'm the RPG Chick, and this is going to be an occasional series. So who wants to see me fight like 100 decaying rats or, you know, self-eater snakes or whatever? Bit of info before I start playing my erudite necromancer. Project 1999 has the first classic EverQuest plus the first two expansions, The Ruins of Kunark and Scars of Elias. This is a free server generously hosted by some very awesome people. Thanks so much, guys! And, right, to play this, what you need is a copy of EverQuest Titanium. I was able to find mine used on Amazon to the tune of $63, including shipping. But there are other sources. Yes, I'm actually playing a female character, and I am female. We are out there, people. I'm going to be role-playing my character to a certain extent. I do have some notes. This isn't scripted. But I have notes on what I'm going to say, just so I don't leave anything out. Probably will anyway. I was one of the few on my server anyway, which was Fenin Rao, one of the originals, who roleplayed. Sad to say. I ran into a lot of people who roleplayed, who didn't roleplay, and I roleplayed with them anyway, and they thought it was funny. So, I know the graphics aren't best in this game, but I'm going to try to capture the wonder behind this game. Just being thrown into this world, and it's kind of like real life in a way, because you really don't have a clear vision of where you are, what's going to happen to you, and if you die, it's a big deal. Yes, you do respawn, but you have to go back and get your stuff. You might have died on the bottom of some dark, deep dungeon with all your goodies, and you have to go back down there and get your stuff. Where most likely, you know, none of your excellent gear that helped you get down there in the first place. And, no food or water, so... good times. Good times. So I'm choosing Necromancer because I just love the class. I played quite a number of classes in the original game. I played a warrior, an ogre shaman, a cleric, paladin, necromancer, obviously, an enchanter, and a magician. And with most of them, I didn't get past the starting levels. I just lost interest in them. My highest character is the Shaman, and I have to say it was a hard choice between picking Necromancer and Shaman. The great thing about these classes also, they have good solo ability. So, if you don't want a group at the moment, you don't have to. I mean, you might have to travel somewhere else to find something more suited for you to fight. And you're mostly stuck to fighting outdoors, kiting stuff, or in the case of a shaman, rooting and, you know, casting disease, poison spells and that. So, as far as starting stats, erudite starts with the most intelligence of any race. So we have 30 points to spend. I'm not sure why dexterity is here. I think it helps with concentration to get hit and getting your spells through. I'm not sure if that's even a thing on Project 1999 or if that's later at EverQuest. I'm not sure. Because EverQuest as itself is still around. After all this time, something like 17 expansions or something like that. They've changed the game so much though that it's just... they've trivialized the importance and the toughness of things. This is hardcore here. So, agility, if you're under 75, you get an armor class penalty. So let's put that up to 75. Putting 5 points in, just a minimum so that we don't have an armor class penalty. As it is, we're going to be far too easily to be damaged to begin with. Stamina is always a good choice for extra hit points. And the rest is going all into intelligence. You know how many necromancers start with 137 intelligence who aren't, what do you call it? Erudite. So some of these faces are a little sad looking. Pretty exotic. The hair on this one's kind of nappy. What do you think? She's pretty regal looking, huh? I like the skin tone on this one. Torn. Definitely don't like that one. Eh. A little too haughty. She looks very sad. She looks alien. No. She looks old. It's between these two. What do you think? Of course, I'm going to choose it before you guys can say anything. The thing about choosing this is the headband is a permanent item. I have a feeling a lot of people would choose this one. So I'm going to go with this one. She's really regal looking, isn't she? Anyway, next. Hopefully this records right. Oh, get out. All we can choose is the faceless. I thought we could also choose Bertoxilus, whichever one that was. Bertoxilus is the lord of the plague bringer. I can't choose the plague bringer? Damn it. Well, I guess we have no choice. Now, I have a choice. I have a bunch of names to choose here, and hopefully my first one in honor of the tall man, Angus Scrim. Name has been rejected. Oh my god, I'm sorry, Angus. Okay, I have a few other names to choose. Where are they? I have a note here. Oh, okay. Why is Phantasm? Maybe it's a name of a creature in the game, or someone already has the name. Well, it says it's been rejected. I don't have any idea why. Malediction. Rejected. What? Macabre. Rejected. What? Why? Abyss. Ugh. Leave this crap, guys. I'm sure darkness won't be. This is way too common, and it's probably the name of a spell or something. I'm running out of names. Obsidian. Last name, Entertainment. Nope. Atrocity. No! I'm running out of names. My god. What about the name of my old... This is the name of my original character. Well, there you go. Works here too. I just kind of like those other names better. Okay, so now I'm gonna mess with my interface. You can drag all these things. Don't show tips. I'm just gonna drag them to the center because they tend to get messed up. Because I'm going to change to the Duxa UI. I'm gonna have all this stuff. I'm gonna put links in the description of this video. Of well, as far as finding the EverQuest Titanium for the client, you're pretty much on your own. Sorry about that. I don't condone pirating, but you know, what are you gonna do? So I did manage to find mine online. There are ways to go about it. I guess just try Google. You know, just beware for adware, spyware, stuff like that. And okay, so I'm gonna have a link to that. Well, to the Project 1999, their guide for setting up. And then there's a step-by-step thing you have to follow. You have to create a forum ID, and you have to create another ID, I forget the name of that, for the server itself for you to log on, so that when you log on in the game, your name and password matches the name and password on the Project 1999, you know, website. Those have to match. And your forum ID should be something, a different name and a different password. And also, I'm going to give a link to the Duxa UI. Once you have installed it, you just go like this. And you got a new UI. And I'm going to mess around with this for a few minutes. Get this Windows all to how I like it and change the keys how I like. So, be right back. Okay. Actually done. I have everything set up just the way I wanted. I'm really picky with that. What I did was I have one for combat, skills, experience with everything else. And as you can see, say we'll go here, tell we'll go here, group messages, guild messages, out of character, shout, and all emotes will go here, so I won't miss them because as you can see, there's a lot of spam in the combat and everything everybody else is doing. If somebody hits somebody, you know, people are casting spells, these are NPCs, they all go in here, so just so I make sure I don't miss what somebody might be saying. And a few things, I think I'm going to make an annotation to skip all this if you don't want to hear all this. These are my options, you can't really see everything, but I made the font Lucida Console. It seems to be easier to see. If you're watching this at under 1080p, it might still be hard to see, you know, the text here. But this is pretty much the largest font that doesn't look stupid. Mouse look, keys, hot button. I have sense heading set to this. So whenever I move forward, you have no idea what direction you're facing. It automatically will sense heading. And the way I have it, I have mouse look, which is the other mouse key. You have to hold it down. And instead of turning, I strafe. I'm pretty sure that's the way I did it in the original game. More whole keys. So this is me. So if I look at more whole keys, this is my target. And this is me. I have 20 hit points, 29 mana. For whatever reason, I don't know why this isn't 29 out of 29 the same way the hit points are. And these are my, you can barely see, my attack. Like, I guess, disease. Yeah, all my resistances are here. This is how much I attack for. This is my hit points, my mana, and I believe this is endurance. And here's my XP bar. It will actually give you a percentage of how much you need to get to the next level, or how much you have done in this level, actually, more correctly. So, yeah, and here, or if I had people, if I was in a group, here would be their hit points. This would be all my spells, if I had any loaded. And this is the same as my inventory, it's just a quick bar. So, yeah, pretty much. There's a bunch of other things, I mean, I don't even know. I mean, besides the way I set the keys up, I know I changed a couple of these. We're purple. That's really hard to see. I've watched other people's videos where you just can't read the purple text. Like the who command comes up purple normally. But I have it white. Oh my god, there's a guild called Super Friends. So there's a lot of people in the zone right now. In Pain Eel. This is where the evil races start. The are there erudite shadow knights? I'm not even sure, but definitely the necromancers like I am. So you start out with skins of milk, and if you hold it down, this is a refreshing drink. And bread cakes. This is a hearty meal. You have a dagger, which we can put. Wait. This is range ammo. Oh, it's up here. Boom. So now we're wielding the dagger. This is our Tome of Order and Discord. You hand this into the Priest of Discord if you wish to become a PvP player. We do not wish to do that, so we're going to destroy that. And actually, the destroy button is here. Yes! Because we don't want to do that. Alright, so here we've got spells. Minor shielding. You see the races that can play it. That can use it anyway. And life tap. Which, if I remember right, this is a spell that takes energy from you, or from energy to you from your enemy. So we have to scribe this into our spell book. Well, that was quick. We just used to have to wait a while for that. I don't know if it's because these are first level spells, or they've made the game a little more tolerable in some ways. Very minor ways. So the life tap. I'll just make this number one. Okay, I guess it's this that takes longer. Up, down, X. Okay, so we have life tap. And minor shielding. I might be going from habit here. This might be the way. I tend to make the my primary attack spells at the top. At least that's the way I think I did it. So now, this is on ourselves only. So now we have a little buff here for minor shielding. Greetings, Incarnus. My wares are few but valuable, including books of research into the less widely known arts of necromancy. Perhaps you should have a look. Alright, so this is stuff that he's selling. Of course, we have no money at all, so I'll have to remember him for later. Hello, Incarnus. Interested in the art of research? I have several tomes which may aid you in such a pursuit. So basically, I'm looking for quests. You can just go out and start killing stuff, but there are people who will... Oh, that's your guildmaster to train skills. There are quests you can get, which you're going to pick up rat fur and snake skin anyway on your travels, unless you leave it, so you might as well pick up the crap and turn it in as you fight things, right? Greetings, Incarnus. You've come to me searching for tasks, and tasks I have. Would you judge yourself an experienced heretic, or one who has much to learn? I have much to learn. Very well, Incarnus, I do have a task for you. There is an old and frail erudite male who now lives in Taxulia named Agilthin Desmore. He has left the ways of Kazakh Thule and no longer practices our craft. He has been stripped of his power and wealth, so he spends his time fishing by the river. Our great Lord of Fear has decreed that his life is forfeit. Slay him and bring me proof of the deed. Well, it's going to be a while till we do that. I'm sure he's not a level one. I mean, maybe he is. You never know. Did I talk to everybody? Is this the merchant? Yeah. Out we go. I'll get you more used to the interface. It'll probably make me unused to the way other games work. Oh, I think I was using the wrong key. What could be in here, though? Cool. Oops. Hello? Well, that was great. So you see, every time I move forward, I'm working on my sense heading. Alright, so this is dead end. Dead endo. Maybe I'm gonna change my keys back. Cool. Ghosties. Hail, ghosty. So if you click, this tells you two things. Judges you amiably. Well, these doors closed. And so this tells you what the faction is. You're definitely in. She likes you, you know. I don't think this is the highest level. I think the highest levels regards you as an ally or something like that. What would you like your tombstone to say? Means that she could really wipe the floor with you, probably one hit with these guys. Hail? No. See, these are all spooky, scary things, but, yes, they don't speak. But they like us because we're evil. So as far as my character, I always like to roleplay, and I was trying to think of, well, I do like to help people in the game. Because, you are spooky. What fool does seek counsel with this spirit? This fool, but you actually have nothing to say to me. I can't go. Oh, this is the bank. Hi there, Incarnus. Just browsing if you see the Invoke Shadow. Oh, this is not the bank. It looked like a bank. Alright, so ingredients, stuff you can sell, most likely. Where is the bank? Getting stuck on stuff in here. Feel free to look through my inventory of spells, but if you touch anything without first buying it, I will have your skin pulled from your flesh. Slowly. Alright. Okay, I think I'm getting used to the keys. So this just puts you back here, which there's no reason to. Why did I start crouching? That does open. Hail. Reclaim. So yes, that was another player right there. This is the bank. Isn't it? How do I bank? Do I have to go in? Okay. I guess we have to go in? That's weird, isn't it? Okay, so here's the banker window. I wonder if I can lock this too. To just go around here or something. So if you had stuff you wanted to keep in the bank, you could put it there. Well, I'm supposed to hand this in. Oh, that's where it came from! Take this note to Coriante Verasu. She is perhaps the oldest living resident of Peniel. She will, with the aid of her many henchmen, guide you in the perilous craft of necromancy. Together, combined with the power of the heretics, you will grow in power and one day exert your will upon the common races and take the place that is rightfully yours. Well, I hailed her and she did not say a thing to me. Come back and mix soon. So if I hail her... Oh, she does say something now. Did I miss it before? Greetings, young one. There are many tasks to be performed aside from your studies. To truly harness the powers passed down to us by your ancestor Marigold. The most basic of these tasks is the gathering of bat wings and snake fangs from the yard outside our city. I'll reward you for every 2 bat wings and 2 snake fangs you bring to me. That's not bad. So really all you really have to say is the word in parentheses. You do not know of Miracle? Well, I even spelled it wrong. You have more to learn of the heritage of the Dark Truth than at first I thought. Miracle was the first high man to unlock the secrets of necromancy and is the founder of our city as well as the creator of the Treacherous Hole. Now the interesting thing about Peniel and the Hole, which is a dungeon, they were not here on launch at all. If you were a necromancer, you started out in, I think, there was a tent out in Toxulia Woods, if I remember correctly. And you're basically, as far as I can remember, you're kill on sight to the members of Eriadan themselves, the people in the actual city. So, as far as I know, this is the only actual necromancer city, is this one, Peniel. Everyone else, you start, like, in a part of the city. Or, who knows? I think if you're a human, you start out in the catacombs. Or you have to find the catacombs, I'm not even sure. So if you give her this... where'd it go? Oh, okay. Can I lock this here, too? How much experience we got? We got 9%, and we got this. You are welcomed into the fold. Now go out and prove yourself, young one. You have much to learn about the Dark Truth. So this is a dirt-soiled robe. Isn't it great? So it gives you an armor class of 2. So I think for that, you have to go into regular inventory. And I'm trying to see where we go. Chest. There you go. So, we need to get what? Snake fangs. Bat wings and snake fangs. 2 each. Turn them in, and you get a little experience, and I think probably a few copper or something like that. At some point, we'll actually start to know what direction we're facing. That'll be a great thing. You think you're heading north? I don't know. Does it ever say that you are heading north? Or does it always say you think? I don't remember. Now, the original game, my shaman got up to 42, and my necromancer up to 20, I believe. Just enough to get a last name. And then I kind of left the game. It's funny with characters, sinfully handsome, they sell stuff, clothes. Godiva's Tasty Treats, get it? Selling food, obviously. The Final Reckoning, what's this? Oh, the Final Reckoning is the bank. False idols. What do you sell? Stuff. Fiery Jewel of the Underfoot. Whatever it is, it sells for a good amount of money. So yeah, I remember passing by that place. I just wanted to know what the hell it is. Not sure what the deal is with the bank called the Final Reckoning. Hell. He's a merchant? Okay. I guess you could easily sell stuff to him without having to go inside the city. Oh, there's more stuff out here. Athenium Necromancia? Hello, do you need something, or did you merely wish to grace me with your oh-so-delightfully perfumed breath? Both. Is she a merchant? No. A funny idea of what passes for judging amiably. And what's at the top of this tower? You know what? How do I get down? Like that. This is a ghoul. And apparently a library assistant. Lots to do! Many books to place and scrolls to file. Feel free to browse, but please, don't make a mess. What a well-spoken... ghoul? Hello, please leave me be. I am studying several interesting essays on mana storage devices. Actually, you're just standing there. Greetings, Incarnus. You have come to the Athenium Necromanita? This place serves as the stores of knowledge for the seekers of the dark truth. I did it! I died. Great. I thought I was in a text window. Hopefully I'm loading into Peniel and not the hole or something crazy like that. So I didn't lose any experience. As you see, I'm still at 9%. Exactly. Oh, I'm in Toxulia Forest. Well then, where was I? Oh, now I'm in Peniel. Okay. What? How am I supposed to get anywhere here? Is there a secret entrance. That's not a secret entrance. Whoops. Oh, wait. Where's the zone? That way? I don't know if this is going to Toxulia, guys, or... Oh, okay. Oh, it's the yard. Okay.